let me borrow that.
Thank you.
Thank you. Quincy's off. Quincy's off.
We shall grow not old, as we who are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
Tell them of us,
and say that tomorrow we give our today.
Thank you.
What took a change of?
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of its roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt round his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and the little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the pole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand in the adder's den. They will not turn, will not hurt or destroy on Almighty Mount. For the Lord will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. This is the word of the Lord. The rector, the Canon Jean Stevenson, should be here today in this place. Sadly, she has tested positive for COVID. She asked me to step into her shoes and pray for her and for all those suffering at this time. And pray for the commemoration for those who died during World War I. Father of all, remember your mercy and look with healing love on all your people, living and departed. On this day, we especially ask you that you would hold forever all who suffered during the First World War, those who returned scarred by warfare, those who waited anxiously at home, and those who returned wounded and disillusioned, those who mourned, and those communities that were diminished and suffered loss. Remember too those who acted with kindly compassion, those who bravely risked their own lives for their comrades, and those who in the aftermath of war worked tirelessly for a more peaceful world. And as you remember them, remember us, O Lord, grant us peace in our time. And the longing for the day when people of every language, race and nation will be brought into the unity of Christ, Christ in you. This we ask in the name of the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace proceed. Kingdom, we pray in the hearts of all the true love of peace, and guide with your pure and peaceable wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility your kingdom may go forward till the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love.
love. In you alone we find safety and peace. We commend to your gracious keeping all the men and women who serve in the Navy, the Army, or the Air Force, who face danger and put their lives at risk so that others might live in safety. Defend them day by day by your heavenly care, and help them to know that they can never pass beyond the reach of your care. Keep alive in them and in us your vision of that peace, which alone we must seek and serve. Amen.
Oh, I've slipped the surly bonds of earth, and danced the skies and lapped the silver winds. Sunwards I've climbed and joined the tumbling night, I've sun-split clouds, and done 100 things you have not dreamed of. Wheeled and soared and swung, high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along, and flung my eager crack at the long, delirious, burning blue. I've topped the windswept heights with easy grace, whenever lark or ever eagle flew. And while in silent, lifting mind I trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touched the face of God.
Ourselves anew to the service of God and our fellow men and women that we may help, encourage and comfort others and support those working for the relief of the needy and for the peace and welfare of the nation. Let us say together, Lord God, our Father, we pledge ourselves to serve you and all mankind in the cause of peace, for the relief of want and suffering, for the praise of your name. Grant us by your Spirit, give us wisdom, give us courage, give us hope, and keep us faithful now and always. Amen. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace, and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you all, and remain with you always. Amen.
Pray! Pray! Jump! Let's go!